In Sushi Go, your goal is to collect the best sushi for yourself and leave your opponents with the leftovers. Whoever has the most points after three rounds wins. We'll talk about all the details later, but first, let's just look at how a round works. You'll start with a hand of cards, and each turn, you just pick one card to play. Once everybody has made their choice, flip over your cards together and play them, then pass the rest of the hand to your left. Take your new hand and repeat. Pick, play, and pass until all the cards run out. Then the round is over. The number of cards you start with depends on the number of players you have. If there are five players, you deal seven cards each, then add an extra card for each missing player. In this case, imagine we have three players, so we'll get nine cards each. Playing all these cards will finish the round, and three rounds make up a game. So gameplay is pretty simple, but the thing is, every kind of card is scored differently, so there's actually a lot of strategy. Scoring can get a bit complex, but don't stress about remembering everything, because there are reminders on the bottom of every card, and also on the back of the rulebook, which there's a link to in this video's description. Let's look at each type of card, starting with the simplest. Dumplings give you a set number of points based on the size of your collection. If you don't have many dumplings, they're not worth much. Like, one dumpling is only worth 1 point. But if you have four dumplings, that's worth 10 points total. Or five or more give you 15 points. Tempura and sashimi are also pretty simple. With these, you get points for each complete set you have. Two tempura give you 5 points, and three sashimi give you 10 points. An incomplete set is worthless. And you can have multiple sets, like four tempura for 10 points. Nigiri cards are each worth a set number of points. Squid is the best, worth 3 points, then salmon gives you 2 points, and egg gives you 1. So they're pretty easy to score on their own, but what makes nigiri special is you can get bonus points if you play them on top of wasabi. So pretend you played wasabi, and a few turns later you decide to play a nigiri. It will go onto the wasabi, and it now gets triple points. So this is worth 6 points now. Just remember that you have to play the wasabi first, and the next nigiri you play has to go on it. You can't choose to save it for something better to come along later. Also, if you play wasabi too late and never put a nigiri on it, then it's worthless. Maki rolls are a bit more complex, because each card can have 3, 2, or 1 rolls on it. And your score is based on competition between all the players. Whoever has the most maki rolls gets 6 points, and second place gets 3. So if the round ended this way, this player with 5 maki rolls would win the 6 points, and you would get 3 points for second place. If there's a tie, like this, then you split the points. So you would get 3 points each for first place, and just ignore second place because two people had first. And just remember to round down if you're ever splitting an odd number. The last way to score points is with pudding. These are weird because they're not scored until the end of the entire game, based on how many puddings you collected throughout all three rounds. So everything else we've talked about is scored and then discarded at the end of each round, when you run out of cards to play. But you save the puddings until you've played through three whole rounds. Then they work sort of like maki rolls. Whoever has the most puddings gets 6 points, and whoever has the least loses 6 points. And again, if there's a tie, you just split the points. Also, if you're playing with just two players, don't give anybody a penalty for the least puddings. Now, there's one more kind of card we haven't looked at yet. That's chopsticks. These are odd because they aren't worth any points. But if you play chopsticks, then on a later turn in that round, you can pick them back up to play a second card from that hand. So having chopsticks at the end of the round won't affect your score. But if you play chopsticks early, they can help you get the best combos. Sushi Go is really simple to play, but there's still a lot of strategy in when you choose to take risks. And it gets even deeper if you start watching what your friends are playing and which card types are most common in the hands for each round. So if you're looking for something quick and easy that's still a strategic challenge, Sushi Go is a great choice. If you're planning on playing with only two players, the regular rules will work, but it's not as strategic or fun. So there are some recommended changes that add a fake third player. You can learn that variant from this bonus video. Otherwise, you're ready to play now. I recommend a quick practice round before you start keeping score. Play hard and have fun. Share this video with your friends so they're ready for your next game night, and please leave a comment recommending what game you think I should teach next, and why. Also, there's a link in the description to a survey where you can give me feedback on this video. Please do so the next video can be even better. Thanks, and I'll see you next game night.